Welcome, YouTubers. Happy holidays. Today, I'm going to show you how to make apple pie moonshine. So let's go. Let's start by talking about the term moonshine. Most people think that moonshine is just unaged corn whiskey, but that's not true. The old moonshiners made a variety of products, from brandy to rye whiskey to, of course, bathtub gin. The term itself, moonshine, is just basically illegally made booze. Now, what we're making today is called apple pie moonshine. And the concept came from the old moonshiners that were wanting to diversify their product. Basically, they took their old corn whiskey, added a little apple juice and table sugar, and there you went. But what we're doing today, I want to consider more of as a liqueur. We're taking raw spirit and we're adding sugar and flavoring. So it kind of makes it more like a liqueur. So let's see what we need to get this project started. This is what we're going to need to make our apple pie moonshine. First, we're going to need 1 quart of apple juice, 2 ounces by weight of brown sugar, a couple of dashes of ground cinnamon, 2 ounces by volume of clove honey, a couple of dashes of vanilla extract, and 8 ounces of Everclear or any overproof spirit of your choice. And you'll also need a 4-quart pot so we can reduce this or cook it in. We've begun to heat the apple juice already, and I've added all the ingredients. I want to talk about the spices, the vanilla and the cinnamon. Most people will be tempted to get a little aggressive with those to really enhance the flavor. But I want to warn you, in making homemade liqueurs and beers, that you want to be careful. These are potent ingredients, and we're again wanting to only enhance the flavor, not dominate. Remember, this is apple pie moonshine and not vanilla moonshine or cinnamon moonshine. Now, this is going to take a few minutes to heat up, but once it starts to boil, we'll let it boil for probably about 30 minutes or so. Just enough to reduce by about 25%. After we're done, take off the heat, and then we'll place in the refrigerator to cool down. Well, our mixture is cooled, and we've added to 8 ounces of our spirit. And that gets us to 40 proof apple pie moonshine. Now feel free to play around with different ingredients, maybe agave nectar instead of honey, or different types of sugar instead of brown sugar. Playing around and experimenting is the most fun part of this process. Well, I take that back. This is the most fun part of the process. Good. Well, if you liked the video, please subscribe down below. And Merry Christmas, everybody.